this emotional appeal that keeps Tyagaraja's composition much higher and appealing to everyone and all. And this is not to say that Tyagaraja was lacking in the Lakshana Jnana. It is due to Tyagaraja Swami that we have so many Janya Ragas today. And this which exists just in one song. Probably that is the only song that we have in that raga, but the contours of the raga, the shape of the raga is so clear right in the first line of the song. That is the speciality of Tyagaraja. The arohana avarohana, the scale of the raga comes right in the first line. For example, say paluku kanda cheranu gerune sagama papas sanidama magarisa. It is so in many every song, almost every song, the first pallavi line gives you the scale of the raga. Marugelara vo ragava damapa nidama sanidama pamagasa damapa maga nisagamada. The whole thing is there. Similarly, every raga for that matter. In a rare raga, vivadi raga, like Manoranjani. Atuka radhani bhag sarima pada tavamagagarisa. I'll sing one song and one more point. Tyagaraja specialized in songs in Deshadi Tala. That is 1, 2, 3. Ta 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 ta. This was popular in the Harikatha tradition with the, what we call Usi Tala. All those things were catchy. And after Tyagaraja, all the later composers like Patnam Subramaniar, Ramnadapuram Srinivas, and all of them followed this tradition of singing to this particular rhythm. But it is Tyagaraja who probably had a taste for it and started it. I'll sing one song in that. Paluku kanda chakaranu gerune paluku kanda chakaranu gerune paluku kanda chakaranu gerune vannathullara nodare paluku kanda chakaranu gerune vannathullara nodare paluku kanda chakaranu gerune vannathullara
Choo choo.
Say the least, the most popular kritis of compositions of Tyagaraja are the Divyanama kritis and the Utsava Sampradaya kritis, which attracted really a great number of people. Like, people could join because the participation gives a great joy. There are many kritis. Rama Rama Nivara Mugama Rama Sita Rama Rama Sadhu Jana Prema Rara Rama Rama Nivara Mugama Rama Sita Rama Rama Sadhu Jana Prema Rara Merugu Chela Mukadu Kamela Rara Rama Karagu such simple songs to songs like Orangashahi, songs like the most complicated kritis, it is only Tyagaraja who could do so much, who could offer such variety, such most simple to the most complicated in all aspects. The beauty of Tyagaraja's composition is when a person wants to look at the musical beauty, aesthetic of it, he gets it. A person wants to look at the lakshana of the raga, he gets it. A person wants to have the feel of rhythm, he gets it. A person wants to see the beauty of the lyric, he gets it. And a person who wants to see God along with Tyagaraja, he gets it too. That is the beauty of Tyagaraja. Now, let's... Thank you. Thank you. Because for lack of time, I'm not able to cover a lot of things, but peripherally I'm doing. See, the Tyagaraja Sadara. The expanse of Begada, he did Lokavana Chatura. See how he handles Begada. kavan chatura. And the way lokavan chatura is an sambodhanam. The way he does it with begada is what is important. Similarly, orangachai. Okay, this way we'll go on with Tyagaraja. Okay, Tyagaraja, look at the na do pa sana ma. The madhyama is the special swara of begada. How right at the outset, ma ga ma pa ta ra na na do pa sana che. This is such a begada has come right in the two lines, the first sangati. You don't feel like adding sangatis to it because you may spoil the beauty. The conception of the composer, I mean, we don't feel like meddling with it. That is the beauty of the great composers. Okay. Now, this is there in every raga, every exposition of every raga, Tyagaraja is able to bring in front of us. That is the greatness of the composer. That is why he is. And my only request to people who are learning these kritis, at least learn the meaning of the word-to-word meaning of the kritis that you are handling, even if not the language. Because unless you understand, unless you appreciate the language, it's difficult to get the complete impact. So it's better for anybody to at least peripherally know what it means. Coming to Dikshitar is something on a higher level, on a pedestal. It is a different level. So we have to go up to be able to go anywhere near him, because Dikshitar is he lived a different kind of life. Though he is totally a contemporary, he lived in Tiruvarur basically, and was a high Sri Vidya Upasaka, and he was not into the society much. He was with introspective. He saw God within more. He did all the Shakti Upasaka. He is a Shakti Upasaka. So he did all the puja, Sri Vidya puja. But he kind of, he was a Vainika basically. So being a Vainika, he could feel the nuances, the little things, what is great about music, and he felt it and he experienced it, and it is for people to go near him to be able to share it with him. He did not come forward to share it. He did not make it simple either. He lived within, he had his own world of music. But nevertheless, Professor S.R. Dey would say, Tyagaraja caught the raga, Dikshitar taught the raga. So I totally agree with that. Because when you look at a Dikshitar Kriti, he had, I don't know how he got the tremendous capability to expand a raga with just four phrases into a Kriti of 8 minutes to 10 minutes. Without any repetition whatsoever, and the melodic beauty, rhythmic beauty, totally intact and amazing. This is Dikshitar. He could expand the raga like Punnagavarali, Ganta, Ahiri, and many, even a small ragams he could handle in such an expansive manner, and he kind of never hurried up anything. It kind of like a flower blooming. Very, very gradually and slowly, the raga grew up. Raga gradually came up to its full shape. That is Dikshitar. And he had I'm going to render one kriti in Yamuna Kalyani, in the which Dikshitar has probably the raga itself he has imbibed from his Benares sojourn. He got it from the north, and the style is also the Drupad style, where he has maintained the majestic gait of the rhythm. So this is Kriti Jambupate in Yamuna Kalyani. See, if you make us sing Yamuna Kalyani, just four phrases, you cannot go beyond that. But see how much he has expanded the Kriti. This kind of a treasure with us as far as music goes, but for the contribution of the three great people who have lived a century and a half before. And we have to be ever thankful to the three for having given us this, bequeathed all this to us. And it is our duty to preserve it in the best way possible, in the authentic form, if we can. Now, we have to go back to the age when these three Mahans lived. It was not a concert arena that they sang for. They sang for their own, their own joy. It is not then the atmosphere, there was a spiritual renaissance, there was a social reform which was coming up, and these great people used music as a medium to reach the goals, to reach people, to attract people's minds to the values in life, resulting to a good character, good relationship in society. It's not merely done with a view of entertaining somebody. No, this is much, much more. The moral values, the spiritual intentions attached to it were something which is very great. At least we should try to understand it, at least to a meager level. Then it will help the art more than anything else. Then, let's come to Tyagaraja first. Tyagaraja was basically, we cannot call him a composer as such. He was a Bhagavata, he was a Bhagavad Bhakta, and he was a devotee. Devotee means total devotee of Rama. I mean, conversing now with Rama and pleading with him and fighting with him, and complaining to him that why people are like this. And many times here, he kind of praised him. He lived with Rama. This is what he did. And then when music, you know, spread, it is not because he wanted it to spread, but then it so happened that people throng in his house and the disciples throng to learn something from him, which in the course of time got, disseminated all around. And he, why? You may ask, why Tyagaraja's songs are very, very popular and not so the other, compared to the other two? Why? Because Tyagaraja basically lived in Devunchavrati style. His contact with the people, local people around, was much more than that of the other two. And the way of living and the style of living, he every day went around the streets of Tiruvayare, and he did not move much from Tiruvayare except for in the last days, the peripheral tour up to Tirupati. He did not move much out of his place. So because he lived in one place constantly, his lifestyle was very similar every day. He had a daily routine of things, of rituals, of his own puja, his own interaction with people. And so he could contribute much, much more. He could relate to people in a much better way. And people came to him. People knew him as an approachable person, a person who really sang every day. They were attracted to his music and attracted, and hence to the ideas. And they kind of participated in whatever he did on a daily basis. And what is musically? This is the social context. Musically, it is, but for Tyagaraja, we can't have such variety. He's a prolific composer in the sense that he has composed for all kinds of contexts, all kinds of requirements, all kinds of levels, all kinds of people, right from the one-line congregational songs to the big songs which can afford a lot of development, which kind of, you know, gave a lot of scope for Manodharma Sangeeta, for the development, and for brain work. And he was a poet. Some of his lines, you know, lyrics are so beautiful. And then he could kind of bring in front of our eyes a scene. He's a dramatist in a way that we can really, you know, when we sing his songs, we can imagine the whole thing happening, some events from the Ramayana happening in front of our eyes. He had that that great capability to the picturization capability he had. And then he has composed the operas. I can't call it operas, but whatever, the Naukacharitram and Prahlad Bhakti Vijayam, which could be enacted, and which had dharus to fit in the context. And there again, the description of the scenes in the Chudare Chalulara, and then the boat goes, Odanu Jaripe, and all those songs are so descriptive of, if only a poet could handle such poetry. And then coming to the Prahlad Bhakti Vijayam, the entry of every character, the very tune says it all. How Samudra Raja enters, how Garuda enters, how Narada enters. Everything is, you know, even the rhythm of the tune, the rhythm, the lyric, everything go hand in hand. They blend so well that, you know, you can imagine things. You can see all the characters in front of our eyes. And then majorly, he brought people together by his Divyanama Kirtis and the Utsav Sampradaya Kirtis. Divyanama Kirtis were such that anybody, even without any idea of the musical details, could join, could be. This brought people to him, you know, kind of people joined him in all his daily rituals. And then this is what probably made his Kirtis more popular. And the credit of making his Kirtis, bringing his Kirtis to the public, goes to the people in Bhajana Paddhati and the Harikatha exponents who used his compositions to a large extent to probably they kind of suited some of his songs to the context of whatever they wanted to say. And then that popularized his songs much more than the other composers. Now let's take a few kritis of Tyagaraja. I'll keep telling you what I mean, the significance of that. It is Tyagaraja who kind of brought the science of music, that is the development of the scientific development of music and the poetry and the devotion aspect, everything together. He has been a bridge between the compositions which were prior to him and then the development of music after him. Tanu anisham nadatanu anisham shankaram nadatanu anisham shankaram nadatanu anisham shankaram namami me manasa shirasa nadatanu anisham shankaram namami me manasa shirasa nadatanu anisham shankaram namami me manasa shirasa nadatanu anisham nigamottam samamodakara nigamottam samamodakara nigamottam samavedasaram varam varam modakara nigamottam sam
Sa nom tadari ran Jai Kulai
Now this was a kriti of Saint Tyagaraja which afforded a lot of scope for improvisation, for using the manodharma and the capability of the singer. Now let's go to the capability of picturization, a dramatization of Tyagaraja. How he, you know, we are one with Tyagaraja when we sing the song Entani ne varnintunu shabari bhagyamu. See, we can see Shabari, we can see the elation that Tyagaraja experienced when he had the thought of what, how Shabari was fortunate. I mean, would I ever be fortunate enough like Shabari? That longing to be with Rama, that longing to be blessed by Rama, in spite of being ignorant, Shabari's bhakti, he wanted to attain that stage. He, Prahlada and Shabari were his role models. So this is what we experience here. When we hear the Nirval, you feel, you can see Shabari there and Rama there.
Na wa re 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 na Shabbat.
You can feel the presence of Rama, Shabari offering him, excited. He can't believe. Shabari cannot believe that she is seeing Rama. Kanulara sevinchi. And kammani pala, whatever the little, the trivial things that she has kept for Rama, she is offering. You can see the picture, the way Tyagaraja is able to give you the melodic, along with the melodic picture, he is able to give you the real scene in front of our eyes. This is the greatness of Tyagaraja. The bhava and bhakti and rakti, everything together.
Kanula re sevinchi.
See the conception of the whole lyric and the music. This is a vak gaya kara. Vak and gaya should go hand in hand to suitably. Even Neravella Swara, I feel it's a little too much. It spoils the beauty of the song. Tanu pula karuncha vayuga mulaku mraki ina kula pati samukham puna punara